Sounds delicious.
Oh, Sigma. Perfect timing.
You were in the crew quarters before, weren't you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was. Phi, Alice, and I went through all the rooms.
Did you find anything suspicious?
Like a secret door or something?
We got the golden file. If I had, you really think I wouldn't have told you?
Anything else out of the ordinary, perhaps?
Out of the ordinary? Hmm.
What's this book?
Oh, that's a book of meowt cats.
A meowt?
Oh, sorry. It's just this thing that's happened to me ever since I was a kid. Whenever I start talking about cats, I start talking like one. It doesn't really mean anything.
Okay.
That's weird.
Thanks.
So what's the cat book about?
Oh. Well, there's this quantum physics thought experiment called Schrodinger's Cat. This book talks to meowt it.
Oh, yes. I've heard about that. A cat is put in a box with a device that has a random chance to release a poison which will kill the cat.
What?
That means the cat is both alive and dead until someone opens the box.
What?
Something like that, right?
So he kills cats? Meowby?
What?
I don't really know anything about a meowed it. I'm telling you what Fight told me.
So it probably isn't gonna give us any hints then.
Thanks for playing along, Quark.
Quark, you're doing it too.
Oops.
That's really cruel. Well, what about you guys?
What do you mean?
You checked out the lounge with Clover and Ten Miyoji, and Quark was in the infirmary with Dio and Luna. Anything suspicious there?
Well, this whole facility is pretty suspicious, but I suppose that's not what you meant. Well, the puzzles in the lounge were lunar eclipse themed.
Lunar eclipse?
Yes. Apparently, there's supposed to be a lunar eclipse on December 31st, 2028.
So, cool.
All the puzzles were related to that somehow.
Isn't that this New Year's Eve?
I suppose it is. Well, I can't say I know what year or even what day it is, but Clover was saying something to that effect.
31st, huh? I'd been knocked out at dawn on the 25th, so 31st would be 6 days after that. Yes. Lunar eclipse. What did it have to do with any of this? Try as I might, I couldn't think of any way an eclipse could be connected to our abductions.
What about the infirmary, Quark? Did you find anything there?
Yeah, we did find something. Just one thing, though.
And?
Dio and Luna didn't tell you?
No.
Okay, I got it right here. Just a second.
Just a sec-o. Quark reached into his pocket and pulled out what appeared to be a newspaper clipping. My throat began to tighten as I read it. Radical 6 injection spreads. Third one. Cure continues to elude authorities. The Radical 6 virus continues to spread across the globe like wildfire. The WHO has confirmed that the death toll is estimated to have passed 100,000 victims. Immediate quarantine of any infected patients is strongly advised. Is this for real?
It seems a little hard to believe.
If it really is some kind of pandemic, though, that sounds like a pretty big deal.
Yes, it does.
There hasn't been anything on the news, though. This is the first time I've even heard the term Radical 6.
If it is true, then I worry about what might be happening to the world outside. Is there a pandemic raging on the other side of these walls?
Maybe. Clover's voice shattered the silence.
You guys! Hurry! You need to come with me!
Okay.
Has something happened?
randomly, if someone actually, like, burst in the door, said, guys, hurry, I need you to come with me. Do you stop them in the urgency to get information? Or if you trust the person, do you just get up and go? I feel like I would get up and go and say, what's happening as we're going? Because if we keep talking like this, we're wasting time, and they obviously are in a hurry.
I mean, sort of. I mean, we found something.
Incism brings up a good point. Would I trust anyone here? Obviously not, because that's how the character's going. They don't trust anything. Hey, guys, I found something. Are you sure? Yes. It's right here. Are you sure, though? I don't trust you. So, yeah. That makes sense.
What did you find? It's horrible. It's really scary.
Horrible.
Oh, never mind. Just shut up and follow me. You'll understand when you see it.
Where is it?
It's right over here in the next room. Just follow me.
So you moved over to room 2? Clover was the first in the room, followed quickly by me, Kay, and Quirk. She said nothing, just pointed under the bed. The three of us crouched down and followed her finger. There it was. Wow, we missed that. Wait. We had to pull down all the beds. Who would have seen this?
I think it's a bomb.
No way.
So, thank you, Sigma.
I'm trying to look at the background. I think it's a different room.
Goodbye.
Bad timeline. Of course. It was the same bomb I'd seen in my vision. Then it hadn't been an hallucination. That's even more worrisome, actually. Had it actually been a premonition?
We need to tell everybody!
No, it's all right. Luna's out rounding them up. They should be here in just a few seconds.
Let's all fit in this small room.
See?
Where is it? Where's this bomb?
No sooner had she spoken the words than the rest of our fellow captives appeared. Luna pushed through them all and pointed to the bomb.
There. You see?
I have a question. Okay. Ooh. Okay, I was wondering what that choice was. It was when we picked Ally over Trey. Okay, I was wondering why we forked off. For several long moments, we stared in silence. Slowly, we began to eye one another. Old suspicions suddenly reawakened. It was Fi who finally broke the silence.
Doesn't look like it has a timed detonator. There must be a remote somewhere.
You're right. It'll probably use an active button or a switch of some sort, not a dead man switch. If we can get it, we should be safe as long as we don't press the button.
Who was the first person to find this?
Me. And Luna. We found it while we were searching this room.
I thought you and Luna were in the lounge.
Well, yeah. We looked all over, but we couldn't find anything there.
So we gave up on the lounge and came here.
Okay.
I can confirm that. I wanted to look around the lounge some more, so I stayed back. You guys must have found it when you got here, then?
Yes.
How did you know it was a bomb?
Would we have found it if we came here first?
Well, I mean, I could tell just by looking at it.
Why?
Well, during my train...
Clover!
Clover's eyes widened and she clapped her hands over her mouth.
Anyway, this is definitely a bomb.
What is she training to be?
I guarantee it.
How do you know?
I just do, okay?
You sounded pretty sure about the switch, too. How do you know all this?
Let's just say it's an occupational hazard.
What kind of occupation do you have?
I can't tell you that.
Spare me the bullshit. This isn't time for keeping secrets.
Please, just trust me.
No, you hit betray! I'm not gonna trust you. Get away from me.
Look, I know I'm repeating myself, but I'm sure that's a bomb. And it's not just any kind of bomb. It's an antimatter bomb.
Antimatter?
What?
Wait, you mean a bomb that uses annihilation energy?
Oh, you know what that is? Anyway, yes, you're right.
What's annihilation?
Okay, maybe he's not a smart young boy. Or he's playing the kid.
I would have thought you'd know.
Huh? Why?
Well, your name is Quark. You do know what that means, right?
Yeah. Grandpa told me about it. He said it's an elementary particle. One of the smallest bits of matter. But I don't really know anything else.
I see. Can you explain it to him, Tenmyoji?
Me?
Well, you know him best. I thought you could explain it best.
Let me think. I don't know. It's hard to think of a way to explain it in simple terms.
You want me to do it?
Yes, please.
Come on, Fi. Fi nodded and turned to Quark.
Okay. To begin with, we usually refer to bits of matter as particles, but there are also these things called antiparticles.
We're about to be learning.
For example, an electron is a particle with a negative charge. It has a sort of opposite, which is the antiparticle called the positron. It has a positive charge instead of a negative one, like the electron. So, protons have antiprotons, and neutrons have antineutrons. Antimatter is a general term that covers all the antiparticles.
That was simple.
The thing that's interesting about antimatter is that because it's the opposite of normal matter, when they collide, they both sort of cancel each other out. When they cancel each other out, though, it releases a whole bunch of energy. That process is called annihilation. So, an antimatter bomb is a bomb that uses annihilation energy.
Sorry. I don't really get it.
Oh. All right, how about this? You've got men and women, right? They're kind of like complete opposites.
Amen.
What happens when you put them together?
Babies.
Well, if there were, quantum men and women, then when you put them together, they'd disappear. Because their opposite elements cancel each other out. Like when a plus cancels out a minus, you get zero. That's annihilation. But when you get annihilation, you also get...
I know! A baby!
Exactly. In this case, the baby you get is the energy from the annihilation.
You think this is the worst explanation you've ever heard, Evie? Well, we're explaining it to a little kid.
It's not a real baby, of course, but like a baby, it's got all sorts of potential to do amazing things.
That's kind of a strange explanation.
Hey. You do better.
You followed it, though, right?
Yeah!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Quark's gonna go make some babies.
Isn't going to be making a baby. Just how big of a...
Baby?
Just how big of an explosion are we gonna get here?
It's pretty simple, actually. Just use Einstein's E equals MC squared. The mass lost during annihilation will be converted to energy, so...
So you would take the total mass of matter and antimatter and multiply it by the speed of light squared. That should get you the amount of energy.
Well, the speed of light's pretty slow, right? Right? So it shouldn't be that big.
For example, let's say that it has 350 milligrams of antimatter. That would mean there would also be 350 milligrams of matter, right?
So you'd have 700 milligrams total.
Yes. That means annihilation would produce roughly 63 trillion joules. That's about as much energy as the Hiroshima bomb.
What the? You've got to be kidding me. But there's only 350 milligrams of stuff in there.
700.
Well, technically it's 700 milligrams since you have the matter and the antimatter.
That's not the point! We're talking about something that weighs less than a gram, being equal to a bomb that weighed like 10,000 pounds!
Yeah, they did it wrong.
Don't get so excited. I think I know what kind of bomb this is. It's probably using antihydrogen. There should only be about 25 micrograms of material in there.
That's less than a thousandth of a gram. So you'd only get about 45 billion joules of energy, right?
Only!
What does that mean?
About as much explosive power as one ton of TNT.
Okay.
A ton?
Yes. Well, approximately.
And how exactly should I not worry about that? That's enough to blow up a 10-story building!
Mm-hmm.
True. But it's a lot less powerful than an atomic bomb.
As explained earlier.
We don't know how big this place is. If we can get far enough away from the bomb, we might have a chance of survival.
Perhaps, but how do we know this is the only bomb?
What do you mean?
Look at it carefully. It's got a number 3. Do you see it? If the bombs are numbered...
then there could be a number 2 and a number 1.
Yes. There's no way to know if this is the final bomb, either. There could be a 4th, or a 5th, or...
a lot.
Anyway, we can't just sit here and do nothing. We should move it.
Somewhere. Dio stepped forward and reached for the bomb.
No! Don't touch it!
Alice grabbed Dio by the wrist and jerked him away from the bed.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Have you got a death wish or something? This bomb is here because somebody planted it. Do you really think they didn't rig it to go off if some idiot tried to move it?
I mean, we won't know if we don't try. And if we try and die, we won't know. Because we'll blow up.
Then what the fuck are we supposed to do?
Also, there's no real safe place to put it.
We'll just have to leave it be for now. Until we can find the detonator or figure out how to turn it off.
Then you're telling us we should just prance off and ignore the incredibly deadly bomb that is probably gonna kill us all?
There's not much else we can do.
Do you know how to turn it off?
Well, there is a way.
Then spill the beans, lady.
Thanks, Stay Hydrated Bot. You're a boss.
How do we turn the damn thing off?
There should be an emergency deactivation password. If you enter that password, the device should, well, deactivate.
So we just need to get this password.
Yes, that's right.
But there's no keyboard or anything.
Look again. You see it? Right here.
Look again. Look again. I see it. The size of a man's hand.
If we can find the password input device, we just connect it here. Then we can enter the password.
So nobody sleep on that bed.
Who would do something like this?
I have no idea. But we can figure out when they did it. When you and I searched this room, we didn't find anything, right?
No.
So that means the bomb must have been planted after we'd left.
After we left, huh? But when we went to check the chromatic doors, we were all there. And after that, we'd all been around the other people. There's no way anyone could have snuck off to plant it, unless their door opened.
I don't know about that. After we finished the AB game, we all split up. But if someone planted it right before then...
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah. You don't know, do you? Before we went off to the three rooms, we searched the hallway. Everybody was all split up.
Yeah.
And you could just open the door.
Anyone could have come by here then. It would have been easy to sneak away.
You know, I don't remember seeing you around, Sigma. What were you doing?
I was just kind of deep in thought, I guess? Oh yeah, I stayed behind the warehouse when you guys went off. Because I have bombs all the time. Why are you guys giving me that look? You don't think I planted it, do you?
I never said that.
Not out loud. You gotta be kidding me. I don't know anything about this bomb.
Really? Are you sure?
Nobody believes anything anybody says.
Back when we were in the AB room, you said you saw the moment when the bomb exploded.
That was just a... I can only say premonition. If they didn't think it was the worst lie on the planet, they'd think I was insane. That's a lot of ellipses. Ellipsi? Wait. This doesn't make any sense. According to Tenmyoji, any one of us could have been in here. Why am I the only one who's under suspicion? Also, there's no way to know the culprit here is actually one of us. Maybe there's someone else in here, and they set us up the bomb.
Impossible.
Why?
There's no way that would get past Zero. And there's no way Zero would let anybody do something that would get in the way of the gang going forward.
How do you know?
What?
When you say Zero, you mean the AI, right?
Of course.
This is confusing. From now on, let's refer to the real Zero, the one behind all of this, as Zero Senior. Which would, of course, make the AI Zero Junior.
That's why you said Zero Junior before. Okay, that makes more sense.
Okay, fine with me. Anyway, whichever one it is, they're not going to let a tenth person in. There's no way.
What if the tenth person is Zero Senior?
I don't think it could be.
Why not?
Well, Zero Junior said so. He said that the real Zero was one of us.
No, he didn't. He said it could be. Fine Clover were right. There could be a tenth guest. And Zero Senior was, without a doubt, one of us. But if that was the case, then could Zero Senior have planted the bomb? If not, then who had? Alice? Dio? Luna? Kay? Clover? Tenmyoji? Why is he the only one with a Japanese name? It makes no sense. Phi? Or... It seemed insane, but could it have been Quark? No, why would Zero Senior have gone through all the trouble of setting a bomb? To make this game more exciting? To make it seem more dangerous? No. It didn't fit at all. But if that was the case, then the person who planted the bomb was someone other than Zero Senior.
Oh no! This is bad!
What?
Press the buttons on your bracelet!
Oh! Balls. Is this for real?
We've only got 4 minutes until the chromatic doors open!
Let's go!
Let's go, then. You're right. This bomb thing is gonna have to wait until later.
Alright, come on, everybody. Guys, I'm gonna go let somebody in the door real quick. I'll be right back.
Chromatic doors have opened.
Is Sorry about that, guys.
5 minutes remain until chromatic doors close.
The doors have opened.
We need to figure out who's going where and fast.
We don't have time to wait for you to figure it out. Just pay attention. I'm only gonna say this once.
I laid out our options. Option A, we can go, I'm Sigma, right? I'm S. So I'm Sigma and Luna. I could go with Clover. I could go with Alice again. Screw you, Alice. I ain't going with you. Or I go with Phi. Screw you, Phi. You're a jerk. I'm going with Clover. We're going to green. No, I'm going with green. I'm going with Clover.
Remain.
We don't have to do the pairs of threes, do we? No, that was a rule. That was just explaining that you can go through whatever you want.
Or we'll never have time to argue it out. Why don't we let the people who are at the most disadvantage right now decide?
Most what?
The people who only have one BP.
Oh, so that'd be me, you, and Ten Myoji.
No way. I refuse.
Well then, what would you suggest?
We'll be fair and take a vote.
So we all just, like, raise our hands for the option we want?
Exactly.
So which one do you want, Alice?
Option C. I want to go with Sigma and Luna.
I ain't going with you, girl! No. Tough. Pick something else.
My. Looks like you're not so fond of me anymore.
No.
Do you agree with him, Luna?
I'll just let Sigma decide.
Fine.
I'd like option C, too. Clover and I were a pair for the first round, so I feel that I can trust her. What about you, Quark?
That's fine with me.
So that's 3 votes for option C, counting mine. How about the rest of you?
I'd like to pair up with Sigma and Luna, too.
Do we pair with Phi again? Phi or Clover, chat? What do you think? I ain't doing Alice. Sigma would like to go with Phi as well. Are you good with that one?
Sure. I really don't mind.
Now we've got 3 votes for option B.
I'd like to go with option A.
You want to pair up with Alice? Phi is very self-serving. You're a strange duck.
How about you, Ten Myoji?
I don't mind going with option A.
1 minute remains until chromatic doors.
You think I should?
Close.
It's better to keep Phi on my team. So 2 votes for A, 3 votes for B, and C. If Clover's vote doesn't decide this thing, we're gonna have to figure something else out.
Which one do you want, Clover?
I wanna go with option C. Quark chose Ally in the first round, and I was with K in the first round.
Then that's what we're doing.
Oh, we don't even get a choice. Option C had 1 with 4 votes. We're almost out of time. Okay. And I didn't exactly have a convincing argument. I was going to have to go with the majority.
10 seconds remain.
We don't even get the vote. Cool. Both, like, bad kind of cool. I would have liked to have voted.
9, 8, 7.
The doors are closing. Let's go!
Come on, Luna, hurry up! We've got to get to the blue door.
Right.
Luna, Alice, and I dashed toward the blue door. I looked over my shoulder in time to see the others disappearing into their doors. Clover, Quark, and Kay ended up with the red door. And Phi, Dio, and Ten Myoji had gone to the green door.
2, 1, 0. Chromatic doors closing.
There are three doors here.
It looks like they're all locked, though.
Does that mean this is just a dead end?
Well, there's a weird lever thing over here.
Try pulling it.
How about you try pulling it?
Hey, what's with all this hostility?
Because you're a jerk.
Are you still mad about the last AB game?
Yes. Of course I am.
Please don't fight.
There's a reason I didn't want to go with you.
We need to work together, or we're really going to be in trouble. Please? Very well. I'll pull the lever then. Is that okay?
Yeah, go right ahead. See if I care.
She's reminding me of Fluttershy so much right now. One of the doors opened.
But only one. I wonder how you open the other ones.
Who cares? We should get moving.
Ooh. Hey. Underground little garden? What is this place? Don't tell me we're somehow managed to get outside.
I doubt it. Look up. There's a ceiling up there.
I remember the door said Bee Garden or something. What's the Bee Garden?
It probably stands for something. Maybe beautiful?
Eh?
This feels like a whole other little world.
Like an oasis in the middle of all this metal.
I feel kind of weird saying this, considering where we are, but this place feels so liberating. All of this green, it's wonderful.
It's huge, though. We'll wear ourselves ragged trying to search the whole thing.
This must be the exit. Dang it. Well, so much for this being easy. It's locked.
We should split up and look around.
Okay.
Agreed.
Let's get to it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine endings that we'll get to.